What's up everyone, Takedown here. As I seem to mention on my channel time and time again, I used to work retail automotive parts and service. I worked that for 5 years. And over that 5 years, I came across a lot of secrets that customers either A, don't know, or B, employees don't tell. So today, I decided to share a lot of these secrets with you. Let's get right into it. So even though I worked Canadian Tire Automotive Parts and Service, a lot of these secrets I am going to be sharing can be applied to any retail store. So I'm going to start off with the ones that I think people are going to benefit the most as we move forward into this Christmas season. Now, most of the time, employees will not mention this to you. So the first one here is a big one, and it's going to help people save money. You guys might see a lot of retail stores now release their weekly sale flyers, and a lot of customers believe that everything that is in these flyers can only be bought at that sale price for that week that is listed in the flyer. But in reality, items can be bought 2 weeks before the sale starts or 2 weeks after the sale ends. So since we are getting closer and closer to Christmas and people are starting their Christmas shopping already, that's why I wanted to share this retail secret first, just because I think a lot of people are gonna benefit a lot more from this secret. Most employees can check future sales for all items that are in the store. Now, what I mean by most employees, usually it is only the full-time employees that have this power. So if you do have an item in mind and you haven't seen it go in the flyer on sale for a long time, you can simply go into a store, show an employee the product, and they can punch it in the computer and tell you when it is going to be coming on sale next. And I think a lot of people don't know this because employees don't usually tell customers this, but I honestly feel like a lot of people are going to benefit from me telling them this. The next one here can be also very helpful, and it is if the store has their own MasterCard or credit card and you made a purchase with that, whenever you return the item or bring it back for warranty, you do not need a receipt. So as long as you have that store's MasterCard or credit card and you have used it to make the purchase at that store, they can simply look up on their computer to see all the purchases you have made with their card, and they will be able to find the product that you are trying to return or warranty, and they will simply use that as the receipt. And they'll know right away when you bought it, they'll have everything right there, so you no longer need the receipt anymore. Warranties can get declined if a customer is yelling and screaming at an employee. So even though you brought an item in that could or should be warrantied, if you're yelling and screaming at the employee, they have the right to decline the warranty. Now at this point, usually the customer gets even more angry and pissed off and starts yelling and screaming a lot more. Now if a manager comes over and you're yelling and screaming and it's about a warranty, most of the time they'll try to do up the warranty as fast as they can just to get you out of the store. But if you are yelling and screaming at the manager still, sometimes they may decline you as well and ask you to take the item and please leave their store. Now the last one here is also about warranties, but it's more about the automotive portion of retail stores. Now whenever it comes to automotive parts, most of the time, you do not need a receipt whenever you are returning or warrantying the item. This only applies if the employee actually did their job. Because if they did their job right, all parts should be put on work orders, meaning the employees would have gotten your information, put it into the computer, done up an invoice for the items, and gave you the invoice, and that is what you use to pay. And these invoices are usually saved in their system for many, many years. Now, if the employee didn't do their job, didn't put it on an invoice for you, then you would have to bring in your receipt whenever you were to return or warranty an item. Now, my advice to anybody whenever it comes to automotive parts is to make sure that the employee gives you an invoice for the items. It is extremely important, especially whenever it comes to parts that have lifetime warranties, because, for example, in 5 years, if the part you purchased was faulty and it did need to be warrantied, most people do not save their receipts for 5 years, and a lot of people usually misplace their invoices, especially if it's for a very long period of time that they did not need it. So as long as you know the employee did give you an invoice, that means that that invoice is now saved onto the computer, so if you did have a problem years down the line and you know it was a lifetime warranty, you just have to go back to the store, give them your information, and they'd be able to look it up to find the invoice for you. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. This has been my Canadian Tire secrets. But like I said in the beginning of this video, a lot of these secrets can be applied to any retail store. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. I really enjoyed making it. And I hope some of these secrets will help you moving into the Christmas season for your Christmas shopping. Thank you all for watching. I am going to leave this video here. Hope you guys did enjoy. Please take care. Peace.